Do recordings of Swami Vivekananda's voice exist? Fake audios exposed. Hello everyone, I'm Pulkit Mathur, founder of The Spiritual Bee, and it is common to come across videos on YouTube that claim to contain the real voice of Swami Vivekananda. These videos profess to contain the original recordings of the speeches that Swami Vivekananda gave at the Parliament of Religions in Chicago in 1893. So, to find out whether these audio recordings of Swami Vivekananda's voice are genuine or not, I decided to write to the Mumbai branch of the Ramakrishna Mission. The Ramakrishna Mission, which was founded by Swami Vivekananda, meticulously preserves the original letters, photographs, and other historical artifacts related to Swamiji's life. In response to my question desiring to know whether any recordings of Swami Vivekananda's voice exist, Swami Satyadevananda, the Adhyaksha or Secretary of the Mumbai Mission, replied, "There are no audio or video clips of Swami Vivekananda that are found to be authentic by the Ramakrishna Mutt." So there we have it. No video clips or voice recordings of Swami Vivekananda exist. Everything that has come forward so far has been exposed to be a fake, including the videos circulating on YouTube and on WhatsApp. Now the question arises, if these videos do not contain the voice of Swami Vivekananda, then whose voice do they contain? The answer to this question has been excellently researched by a journalist named Soumyadip Chaudhary, who blogs at cuttingthechai.com. Soumyadip, in his investigations, has unearthed that the voice contained in these videos is not that of Swami Vivekananda, but of a person by the name of Subir Ghosh. It is Subir Ghosh who has narrated 5 of the 6 speeches that Swami Vivekananda had delivered at the Parliament of Religions in 1893. Subir did this recording work for a website named Hamara CD, which uploaded the audio series for the benefit of its listeners. This website Hamara CD is now no longer in existence. However, Soumyadip, in an act of great journalism, has unearthed an archive page of Hamara CD, which clearly discloses the name of Subir Ghosh as the recording artist for the 5 speeches of Swami Vivekananda. It is these 5 speeches that some people have unfortunately uploaded on YouTube and WhatsApp under the false title of Real Voice of Swami Vivekananda. Now, if you wish to view this archive page of Hamara CD that has been discovered by Soumyadip, then do visit his blog post that I've referenced below this video and follow the link provided by him in that article. The fakeness of these videos has been further laid bare by some additional incriminating evidence that has been highlighted to me by the Belur Mutt, the headquarters of the Ramakrishna Mission. The Mutt forwarded to me a detailed research piece which was published in their Vedanta Kesari magazine in August of 2010. This research was conducted by M.S. Nanjundiah, a devotee of Sri Ramakrishna who had previously worked with the Indian Ministry of Finance and the World Bank in Washington, D.C. Mr. Nanjundiah, in his investigations, has revealed 4 extremely solid facts which completely seal shut the case and confirm once and for all that the recordings of Swami Vivekananda's voice circulating on YouTube and WhatsApp are entirely fake. The first fact that Mr. Nanjundiah highlights is that when he made inquiries with the Vedanta Society of St. Louis, with the Chicago Historical Society, with the Library of Congress, and with the Art Institute Archives in America, all of them responded by saying that no recordings of Swami Vivekananda's voice were ever made at the Parliament of Religions gathering in Chicago in 1893. This, Mr. Nanjundiah goes on to explain, is to be expected because in those days there was no technology in existence that could record speeches of long duration. What existed was the capability to make small 2-minute long audio recordings, but these two had to be done in a studio setting with the mouth held very close to the recording diaphragm. Certainly, no record could have been made of the longer than 2-minute speeches that Swami Vivekananda delivered in a large hall before thousands of people at the Parliament of Religions in 1893. Secondly, Mr. Nanjundiah points out that before Swami Vivekananda stood up to give his first speech at the Parliament of Religions, Dr. Barrows arose to make a little speech of introduction so as to familiarize the audience with Swami Vivekananda and his background. This fact has been highlighted by Swami Vivekananda himself in his letters. However, in the recording circulating on YouTube, a female voice is heard giving the introduction. This is the second incriminating evidence that clearly indicates that the circulating recordings on YouTube are totally fake. Now, in his article, Mr. Nanjundiah goes on to reveal two more fascinating facts that completely seal shut the case that these YouTube videos claiming to contain the real voice of Swami Vivekananda are completely fake. You can read these last two facts by following the links to Mr. Nanjundiah's research article, which can be found in the description area below this video. So to conclude, all video and audio clips circulating on YouTube or elsewhere that claim to contain the original voice of Swami Vivekananda are absolutely fake. In the same vein, many of the quotes attributed to Swamiji that are circulated on WhatsApp too are fake. With regards to the quotes especially, what happens is that someone picks up a random quote off the internet and then simply types Swami Vivekananda's name below it or attaches Swamiji's photo alongside it. Thus, endowing this fake creation with weight and credibility, this person passes it on to others. The receivers of these fake quotes too, having no knowledge of Swami Vivekananda's actual teachings, having never read his books, blindly forward them to others, thus compounding the problem of misinformation. Tackling this misinformation and wrong beliefs in the spiritual domain is one of the reasons why I started the Spiritual Bee website and its associated YouTube channel. Through both these platforms, I aim to acquaint you with the genuine thoughts of the rishis of Vedanta, such as Swami Vivekananda, whose words in reality contain so much tap shakti or the power of his penance that, as Swamiji himself described, they will burn their way into your brain and you will never be able to get away from them. What this means is that the real thoughts of Swami Vivekananda are so powerful that they will stay lodged inside our mind in seed form and compel us slowly but surely to rise up and transform our bad habits and character and thus ascend to a higher consciousness. Such is the power of truth contained in Swami Vivekananda's words that they strengthen and make loud the voice of conscience within all of us. Swamiji's words thus are not ordinary but are in fact mantras, constantly recalling which we can steadily uplift ourselves and progress towards God realization. So if you want to help me tackle the spiritual component of this terrible crisis of fakery and falsehood that is consuming our nation, which has not spared even our rishis, then do read first and foremost the original speeches and writings of Swami Vivekananda, which have been compiled by the Ramakrishna Mission as the Complete Works of Swami Vivekananda, Volumes 1 to 9. The entire set of the complete works is available for free on the internet. However, in the event you do not have the time to read Swami Vivekananda's works in detail, then do visit the Spiritual Bee website and my YouTube channel and acquaint yourself with the true and genuine thoughts of Swamiji as well as of other great rishis of Vedanta. Thanks for watching, and we shall meet again in the next video.